Morning, folks, and welcome to the Happy Hooker YouTube channel. What a difference a day makes. 24 little hours. Just look at the weather now from yesterday. Morning. This lady thinks I'm absolutely bonkers. Look at the difference in the weather today. Absolute beautiful blue skies. We've been to work and done our morning's work. Gamekeeper John's here. Mithering and beeping. I don't know who he's beeping at. Aren't they a pair of idiots, eh? And Tommy's left his boot open on his car. We're going to nip up to the breakwater, see if we can catch some herrings at high tide on the little sabikis. And then tonight, we're going over to the back of the dock and we're having a fire. And we've got a load of pork there that we're going to cut up and get cooked over the fire with some spuds and such like. Do a bit of fishing while we're at it. I'll shut his boot for him. Should be a fun filled day. Might even have a couple of beers. We'll see. I'll do some more filming when I get to the breakwater. See you in a bit, guys. Right, guys, well, we're down at the breakwater entrance where you've got to park up. I'll just come out of that sunlight. That's a bit better. We are, I mean, you've seen me come here on the boat often enough. We're going around the first bend. Let me just zoom in a little bit. We're going around the first bend there and then down the wall. Once you get past the first bend, you can start flicking about for the herrings. But as a rule, there's a white line on the wall there, just over the red boat, and it goes up to a second white line probably 100 yards before the next bend. And if you just flick about with the with sabikis on, I'll just zoom you down so you're not looking up my nose. If you just flick about with sabikis on, you will, as a rule, you'll catch herrings around the high tide mark. I mean, the best time to get them is absolute first light, but obviously when there's going to work and stuff, it weren't happening, were it? So we'll go chance our arms, see if we can get some herrings and go, so we can go conger fishing tonight. See you in a bit. I'll show you what I'm doing. In fact, you know what I'm doing, you've seen me do it a million times. Oops, I don't know what I've done, I just knocked my camera off. No, we're not. Right, see you shortly, guys. And we're off. We're on our way down. Are you alright though, Tommy? We have to take our, well, we have to let Tommy take his time. What do you think of the walk, John?
Loving it, mate.
It's a beautiful, beautiful day today, isn't it? Where is it? 10 minute walk? A 10 minute walk, if that, a couple of minutes probably, to the designated spot. Hopefully, fingers crossed, we'll get an herring or two. If not, it'll be down to the local tackle shop and buy some fish baits ready for tonight. I'm more interested in the pork, to be fair.
Yes. It's all about the peg.
All about the peg. There'll be no peckers tonight, it'll be porkers.
Porkers, yeah.
I'll let you know when I'm catching herrings. Right, guys, welcome.
That likes the sun.
The first herring's caught. Nice little sabikis. Just give it a flick out and pull, retrieve, pull, retrieve, pull, retrieve. As easy as that. Better get that one in the back. That's giving me a big fat conger tonight. I'll let you know when we get some more. Well, it's just the one herring up to yet. I'm just getting up to where Tommy's gone up now. I think I've just seen him bring a fish up. I think it were a white and it weren't an herring. Beautiful this place. Look at that behind me. Absolutely stunning. Can't grumble at that, can you? Even if we don't get any more herrings. It's just a scenery in the walks worth the while, isn't it? I'm gonna head a bit further up now, up to where the flagpole is, where we get them all on the boat. And see if I can pick one or see if I can winkle one or two out. Alright, are you fishing like that, Tommy? You're not herring fishing. Worm on feather for the whiting. He's whiting fishing, he's not herring fishing, that's why he's not getting an herring. I thought it were an herring, but it's
not the reason I'm not.
Your rod's going. Your rod's going.
I'm not getting a herring if you wouldn't give me a bloody weight.
Take no notice of Tommy. I had all the weights in my pockets and he walked off about half a mile up the thing and I didn't realise he didn't have any weights. That's my excuse anyway. Absolutely brilliant, guys. My mate's just come past on his boat, so I've sneaked on it, and Tommy and John don't know. You're losing the rope here out the back. Tommy and John don't know, so we're just sneaking down the wall. You got it? Yeah? Yeah.
Pull it. You
yeah.
Good, Tom.
Yeah, he's alright. They haven't got a clue I'm on this boat, so I'm just going to give him a quick drive by. They're up here on the wall here somewhere. Watch his line, yeah. I'm just ducking down so they can't see me.
Sorry,
I think that's it. Have they already sussed me?
They're all bringing the lines in as quick as they can. Yeah.
Someone's got a rasp on top there, so.
I knew I'd get out on the boat sometime.
Which way is these rods going?
I don't know. I knew I'd get on the boat! Brilliant! Absolutely brilliant! I've got to get back off the thing yet! just out on this boat opposite the... In fact, we're between the two white lines, I think. And first drop down, mackerel on, gets it to surface and it jumped off. What a shame! And we really need some bait! I better get some work on, hadn't I? It's hard work filming with your camera in your hand on a boat, as we all know. See you in a bit, folks. Here we go. Here's a little herring or a mackerel coming up now. We need up for the conger fishing tonight. Is it an herring? That's a decent size. Oh, how lucky were that?
Well, don't eat that to you, Mr. Rocker. You can have that one.
Thank you very much. All baits are greatly accepted. Right, guys, I'm firmly back on land now. Them two lads have gone to doing a bit more drifting about. They're going to see if they can find us some more herrings. How are you getting on down here, Tommy?
White
and more white in. At least the rod's going round. That's all we can ask for, isn't it? Turn out of that sun. There we go. You might be able to see my beautiful face now. I did enjoy that then. A quick whiz around the harbour, flick the feathers about a little bit. And then back to land. It was hard work getting back on them steps, I'll tell you. Oh dear, just as I turned the camera on, John's just broke his brand new phone! Oh no! Look what he's got, guys! What does that save, John?
The blank.
The blank!
Spotted pecker.
Tommy's been getting a few. John's just got his first one. I'm going to do a slow retrieve on this and see if I can pick something else up. I do enjoy this. It's good fun. It is good fun. I tell you what, pretty much on this breakwater, you will catch fish. They might want to be small, but more or less, people catch fish as a rule on here. It's easy fishing. Absolutely brilliant. Some more herrings coming here for tonight. On the Sea Hog Sanctuary.
You going to catch an herring?
Yeah, just come on. Let me put this rod down. Are you ready? You ready, guys? Watch this. Flying fish. Happy! Happy! Oh, well done! Nice few conga baits, sir!
Well,
hand again! And a
little white in.
Lovely! Nice one, thank you very much!
We might see you on Big Dot later.
Yeah, well, there'll be plenty of pork there coming out of yourselves.
See you
in a bit, guys! Right, guys, before the... Right, guys, before the sun drops down, we're all here now at the Holyhead Harbour. We've got Dave the Slave with us. You know, we all know who John the Pecker is. Tommy the Turd. I thought he was a security guard coming out then. We've got also with us, we've got a big bucket of wood. Well, we've got two big buckets like that. A few bits chopped up for kindling. A nice cooking pan there. Well, to make a fire in that. I get a load of pig on it with some spuds and some sweet corn. And it looks like I've been designated chef while these are all fishing again. Right, I'll get it all underway and I'll do some more filming in a bit. Guys, we can't find a lighter. John's got one in his car somewhere. And whilst rooting in John's car, look what I found. A pair of... Can you please explain
the
these?
Eyelashes, they're not mine, by the way.
What?
I found another lighter, but it's another broke one.
Oh, yeah, I'll sort that out. It's a clicky one. We'll sort that out. I will sort that out. Right, guys. We've got the fire on. The pan's over it. Just going to get set up and let it heat up a bit properly. And then the pig is going in. I'll put the filming back on when I'm slavering and chomping all over everything. See you in a bit. Right, guys. While I'm still setting up and trying to do the cooking, John has got the first fish on of the evening. What do we think it is, John?
Bass.
Is it?
I'm joking.
It's a little bass, is it?
I wish.
I can see that in the water though. And it looks suspiciously like a pecker. Hey. There we go.
It's a pecker.
It's a decent sized pecker as well.
Oh, no, it is, isn't it?
First pecker of the evening, guys.
It's a good peck, that.
There we go. It's time to throw the chops in. Woohoo! Well, guys, we've got some chops in there. In the fire. I still haven't set a bleeding rod up yet. We'll get there shortly, won't we? Just had a bit of a pop there, but not to worry. I brought the van round so I can see what I'm doing. Happy days. It'll soon be feeding time. What do you reckon, Dave the Slave?
Absolutely brill.
Yeah.
Smart.
John?
Yes, look at that.
So then, proper chops, and we've got... There's probably...
You might want to cut the skin off, you know, the rind.
We'll see.
Fry up separately.
I'm just going to put it on the edge in a bit. Well, guys, there's plenty of bites going on, except for on my rod. Because it's not even in the water yet. But look at this. Look at this. Absolutely beautiful. Now, there's four of them, so I've put a spud each in. That with a bit of timber pop. A spud each, because that's all the carbs we're going to need with that lot. Right, guys. Well, the cooking is nearly done. I'm just going to show you some of this pork belly now it's cooked. It is absolutely out of, get them under them headlights, out of this world. I mean, that is a fatty piece, to be fair. How can I get that for you? There we go. That is a fatty piece, to be fair, but the rest of them have just been melting your mouth and to die for. The sweet corns are in, they're not going to be long now. I'm going to have another 10 minutes cooking and then I'm fishing. So hopefully it will be the happy hooker fishing adventure, not the happy hooker cooking adventure, won't it? I'll let you know when I've actually got a rod in the water, eh? Well, the cooking's all finished. That's better. The cooking's all finished. It's time for me to finally throw a rod out. So I'll just show you what I'm using tonight. If you can see in this light, I'm using my trusty Shakespeare agility. I don't even know what the reel is. And the setup I'm going to be conger fishing tonight is, just put that down there a bit. The setup is
he's filled.
A slider. It's a slider down to a big, I'm not even sure what it is. I think it's either 60 or 80 pound mono. Big hook. I'm going to throw a full herring on it, which is there, which we kindly donated earlier by Kay. And I'm just going to fling it out and hope for the best. And then on the little rod, I've still got the sabiki feathers from earlier, so I'm going to stick little tiny bits of herring on that and cob that out and just fish for the peckers with that one. I'll let you know when I've got a fish, which won't be long, trust me. See you in a bit. John's got a big massive fish on here. What is it, John?
Well, it's the biggest fish of the night, so there you go.
Yeah, but what is it? What fish is it, John?
It's a doggy.
It's a what? It's a doggy. There we go. Well done, John.
Look, he's took.
What's it at? A full mackerel.
Oh, I'm going to struggle here. Look, he's took a full mackerel.
Was it mackerel, that?
Yeah, look, as you can see, is the tail, look.
It's spitting, it's gurging it now.
So, it might have been half a mackerel, actually. I'm hoping it's half. Anyway, it's just sicked all over me. But I have got the right stuff in here to get it on hooked.
Well, look what I've got. Yes, you've guessed it. It's a pecker. It's only been in a few seconds. Yeah, nice little bit of vetting, and it enjoyed it and took it. The conger rod is very, very still for the minute, but I'm sure that's going to go whiz bang boogie any minute now. I better get this unhooked and get it back. Not only have I had to do all the cooking, now I've got to put up with that sneaky John casting into my swim, because I'm getting peckers again, and he's not. We've got Dave the slave coming around for a warm. And he's not called the slave because he has to do everything. He's called Dave the slave because he makes me do everything. Slave driver. Look at that fire, it's lovely that, isn't it?
Sure.
Nice and warm. I better unhook this fish and put it back before it ends up dead, haven't I? Well, guys, it's not a pecker, it's a pouting. It's a pecking pout. Pout, 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 peck. Peck, 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 peck. Right guys, it's a bit of a pecker fest. There's nothing happening on the bigger baits. I think Key further up the wall has had, he says he dropped a codlin off on the way up when we were lifting it up. I'm just getting peckered to death, but I am fishing for peckers with my little rod, and I've got my bigger rod out for the congers, but nothing's happening. High tide's not till midnight, and it's about 10 to 9 now. And to be perfectly honest, I've had enough. So get them fingers waggling, press that like button, press that subscribe button, please. And until next time, ta-da for now.